Hi, folks. This is YouTube Zed of the North, inviting you on a journey with me into the palisades and the corridors of logic. Check your preconceived ideas at the doors and keep your emotion in check as we search for the eternal Creator God of heaven and earth and all that is in them. The Old Testament speaks of God and of God sending His Messiah to save all who embrace and follow Him. We have discussed the identity of God in past visits, but to refresh your memory, God, the eternal creator of heaven and earth and all that is in them, is Father Truth. This is the God of the Israel of God. Now the spirit of this eternal creator God is love. After all, we're all still here, aren't we? If hatred was the spirit of truth, then God would have wiped us off the face of the planet eons ago. Yet when we oppose truth, we do have a tendency of getting ourselves into a peck of trouble. Yet God extends His grace that perhaps we learn from our mistakes and turn away from wickedness. Now Isaiah 44 and 6 states, and I quote, "This is what the Lord says, Israel's King and Redeemer, the Lord God Almighty. I am the first and I am the last. Apart from me, there is no God." Now the Almighty, being here in Isaiah identified as the Redeemer, reveals to us that the Redeemer, or the Savior of the world, is the first and the last. Christ in the Greek language means Messiah, in the Hebrew language meaning Savior. Both words refer to exactly the same Redeemer as the one who saves. To redeem something means to save it from destruction. So when we use the word Messiah or Christ, we refer specifically to God Almighty who saves. Apart from this Redeemer, there is no other Savior. The Christ is the Redeemer. The Christ is the Savior. The Christ is the King. The Christ is God Almighty Himself. The Christ is the first and the last. Further study of God's Word reveals that the Christ is the Alpha and the Omega. He has no beginning and He has no end. Tell me, when truth was birthed and by whom? Tell me, on what planet does truth reside?
Or does He not fill the whole cosmos?
Tell me, other than Father Truth, who set the sun in its place, the moon and all the constellations in the heavens? Tell me, who other than Father Truth makes your heart beat and your bodily function convert oxygen to life? Tell me, who other than Father Truth holds the earth in the gravitational pull of the sun and the sun in the gravitational pull of the Milky Way galaxy? Tell me, if you can, who created the elements and who set the physics in place for those elements to combine to create matter? Who sends the seasons? And who makes planet Earth orbit around the sun to create those seasons? Who created the physics of evaporation and condensation that rain form in the clouds to water the earth?
Come on, folks. Show me something which is able to stand against God Almighty, Father Truth. And yet does falsehood the devil not oppose Father Truth? But will he ever succeed in his quest to usurp the authority and the sovereignty of God? I don't think it takes a rocket scientist to realize that falsehood may well rage against truth, but he will never succeed. In the end, falsehood will be chained, and is chained when truth stands up to speak. Now Revelation 1, verses 17 and 18 states, "When I saw him, I fell at his feet as though dead. Then he placed his right hand on me and said, 'Do not be afraid. I am the first and I am the last. I am the living one. I was dead, and behold, I am risen, alive forever and ever, and I hold the keys to death and Hades. Further on in the book of Revelation, we learn that this one who was talking with John was in fact Jesus the Christ. So what does that word Christ or Messiah mean to you? If it does not refer to Father Truth, full of and displaying love, having taken off his immortality and put on mortality, only to be put to death, yet he, risen from the dead, alive and well again, and returned to the Father, there is something definitely wrong with what you have chosen to believe and follow. Join with me next time for more of Have You Considered This?